Hi friends, welcome to SSCG Electrical. In this video, I am going to discuss about important multiple choice questions for SSCG Electrical and other competitive exams like JEE, AE, Public Sector Undertaking Exams, GATE and IAS exams. So in this total duration, so I will cover 875 questions. So daily, some important multiple choice questions from each topic will be discussed. See here in the previous video, 10 questions from DC generators already covered and remaining 10 questions will be discussed now. So along with your regular preparation, if you watch these videos regularly, it will be around 5 to 10 minutes only. If you watch these videos, these topics will be covered. With the practical approach, most of the questions will be covered. Before watching complete video, please like this video and keep watching remaining video. See here. While applying Fleming right hand rule to a direction of induced EMF, the thumb point towards the thumb in Fleming right hand rule, thumb denotes which one? See here, direction of induced EMF, direction of flux, direction of motion of conductor. If forefinger points in direction of generated EMF, direction of motion of conductor, if forefinger points along lines of the flux. So the correct answer, if you know, just answer in comments. The correct answer is direction of motion of conductor, if forefinger points along lines of flux. So D is the correct answer. See here in practical, in this figure you can observe this thumb denotes motion of the conductor. Thumb denotes motion of the conductor. This total conductor is there. This conductor will experience a force in the upward direction. It will experience a force in upward direction, and this is from north pole to south pole, flux lines will pass. Flux lines will pass. So this forefinger denotes lines of the flux. Forefinger denotes lines of the flux and thumb denotes motion of the conductor. Hope you understood. Okay. In the same way, we can understand the middle finger denotes induced EMF and current. This middle finger denotes induced EMF and current. This one, induced EMF and current, this middle finger. This one also just remember. Next question. The bearings used to support the rotor shafter generally. The bearings used to support the rotor shafter generally. Which one? Ball bearings, push bearings, magnetic bearings, needle bearings. The correct answer is ball bearings. So, by using this ball bearings, you can see. So, by using this ball bearings, we can reduce the friction between stationary parts and rotational parts. Friction between stationary parts and rotatory parts, it will reduce. So that is why we use the ball bearings. These are the ball bearings. This we use in DC generators. Next question. In DC generators, the cause of rapid brush wear may be due to severe sparking, rough commutator surface, imperfect contact, any of the above. Which one is the correct answer? If you know the answer, just answer in comments. The correct answer is any of the above. In DC generator, the cause of rapid brush wear may be severe sparking, rough commutator surface, imperfect contact. Any of the above is the correct answer. You can see in practical. So in practical, you can see how commutator appears to be, how brushes. So this is the brush, you can observe. So this is the brush and this is the shaft and this is the commutator. So practically it appears to be like this. This is the brush. So cause of rapid brush wear may be due to severe sparking, rough commutator surface, imperfect contact. Okay, so none of these the that is any of the above is the correct answer. Next question. In lap winding, the number of brushes is always double the number of poles, same as the number of poles, of the number of poles, 2. If you know the answer, just answer in comments. In lap winding, the number of brushes is always same as number of poles. In case of lap winding, number of parallel paths, that is A equals to P, number of poles. In case of wave winding, number of parallel paths is equals to 2. Okay. So based on that, we can say the brushes. Next question. For DC generators, when the number of poles and number of armature conductors is fixed, then which of the winding will give the highest EMF? The correct answer is wave winding. In wave winding, the induced EMF generated is maximum. The correct answer is wave winding. And we can understand from formula also, E equals to pi Z n by 60 into P by A. So sometimes we can write this pi n P by 60 into Z by A. So here you see, for example number of conductors is 120 given. For example, take it, number of conductors 120 given, and in case of wave winding, what happens? This factor becomes 120 by 2. So you will get 60 here. Okay, you will get 60. For example, it was given for lap winding. For lap winding, so number of parallel paths is equals to number of poles. For example, that is 4. Then what happens? 120 by 4. In case of lap winding, what happens? The number of parallel paths is equals to number of poles. So it will be more than 2 mostly. Okay, 4, 8, like that we will take. Okay, so then what happens? 4 means, so 30 you are getting. So you are getting less number. So total, by reducing this number, what happens? The total induced EMF will be reduced for lap winding. So for wave winding only, we will get the highest induced EMF here. Okay, so the correct answer is wave winding. Just remember this, Z by A. Next question. In 4 pole DC machine, which one is the correct answer? See, all the 4 poles are north poles, alternative poles are north and south, all the 4 poles are south poles, 2 north poles follow 2 south poles. The correct answer is alternate poles are north and south. You can see here. Here the field poles. So after winding, this one will act as a north pole and this one will act as a south pole. So these are the alternate poles. So here north pole is there, immediately you are getting south pole, after that north pole, after that south pole. Okay, and remaining things also you can observe here. This is the commutator. This inside, this one is commutator. These are the armature conductors. The circles is there, no? These are the armature conductors, and middle one is the shaft, and these are the field windings. This is the yoke and this is the pole shoe. So all these things you can observe from this. So these are the alternate poles you can observe here. North and south poles are alternative here. So correct answer is alternate poles are north and south. Copper brushes in DC machine are used for which one? Where low voltage and high currents are involved, where high voltage and small currents are involved, in both the above cases, none of the above. Which is the correct answer? Answer in comments. The correct answer is low voltage and high currents. So E is the correct answer here. So generally we use the carbon or graphite. Generally we use the carbon or graphite brushes, but for low voltage and high currents we use the copper brushes in DC generators. Okay. Next question. A separately excited generator as compared to self-excited generator, which is the correct answer? Is amenable to better voltage control, is more stable, has exciting current independent of load current, has all other features. So which one is the correct answer? Has all above features. D is the correct answer. A separately excited generator as compared to self-excited generator has the feature of amenable to better voltage control, it is more stable, and exciting current independent of the load current. So all of the above is the correct answer in this case. So next question. In case of DC machine, mechanical losses are primarily function of. So mechanical losses are due to friction between stationary parts and rotationary parts. So primary function will be current, voltage, speed, and none of these. Which one is the correct answer? Answer in comments. Correct answer is speed. So it is related to, mechanical losses are related to friction between stationary parts and rotationary parts. So it happens due to speed. So speed is the correct answer here. Okay. So mechanical losses usually occurs due to bearings, brushes and wind losses. Okay. Next question. Laminations of core are generally made of, laminations of core are generally made of cast iron, carbon, silicon steel, stainless steel. Which is the correct answer? Just answer in comments. Laminations of core are generally made of, the correct answer is silicon steel. Laminations of core are generally made of silicon steel to reduce the eddy current losses. To reduce the eddy current losses, we use the silicon steel laminations. In practically, you can see. So practically, silicon steel appears to be like this. Lamination of the core in DC machine made up of silicon steel. This is the silicon steel laminations. Okay. So it reduces the eddy current losses in DC machine. These are the some of the important multiple choice questions. In the first video, I have explained 10 questions, and the today's video I have explained 10 questions with practical examples. Okay. So remaining questions also will be discussed in the next videos. So thanks for watching this video. Please like this video and share this video with your friends, and don't forget to subscribe this channel for more videos. Thank you.